was now, he used to sit around and make our own board games. They were pretty shitty. There's one game he made which is Lost. It was based off of Michael Jackson's Moonwalker. Why I'm confessing that, I don't know. Before we take a look at the grand epic, which is Deadly Danger Dungeon, let's look at some of the other survivors. This is some weird spaceship game. I don't remember what the goal was. But from what I can see, you have to run through a minefield, avoid getting sucked up by an enemy ship, avoid aliens with headbands, a puddle of glue, and lots of spaceships that blast at you. That's what it says. You can also get transported to this giant battlefield that takes up 90% of the board. How that worked, I have no recollection. This is one of our favorites, Mischief Night. The whole idea was to go around playing pranks, such as smashing a pumpkin, toilet paper in a yard, soap in the wall, splatting eggs on a wall, throwing a stink bomb at a car, sneaking into someone's house to leave the sink on, throwing a baseball out a window, and literally blocking someone's front door with bricks and cement. Whoever this person is must really hate his neighbors. Then there's this one where you're a robber trying to steal jewelry from a house while avoiding elaborate traps like in Home Alone. This game looks like we never finished. Here's Street Fighter 2. I don't have any idea how this works. I also have no idea why there'd be people watching a fight wearing peace signs. I guess that was the irony. Then we jumped ahead and made Street Fighter 3. I guess we got tired of waiting for the actual game. The characters included Candyman, Japanese Monster, Red Dragon Master, General Slaughter, and Dracula. Yeah, Dracula. And the Transylvania flag is a bat, of course. You can say this right here is the original Street Fighter 3. What in the unholy mother of fuck? What was I thinking to make a board game of Pit Fighter? Now let's move on to Deadly Danger Dungeon. My friends and I remember this one as the most sadistic and punishing game that we ever created. You play as a hapless treasure seeker who falls in a trap, landing in a ghastly dungeon full of unspeakable perils. The goal is to climb your way back out, but you'll never make it without a long streak of lucky rolls. Anywhere you step, there's some kind of hazard that either takes a health point away or kills you instantly. It might be flying arrows, falling rocks, spikes, or a slide that sends you into a volcanic fire. If I remember correctly, you start with 3 health points, but you can raise it if you find it too difficult. It doesn't matter anyway, because there's so many spaces that are instant death. Fuck! Oh my god! What was I thinking to make it this hard? I was an asshole! It's not a linear game, you can't just go straight to the exit. First you have to get a talisman, but before you get the talisman, you gotta get a key. It's a cruel game, built only for the motherfuckers of motherfuckers. And that reminds me. Get your ass over here, you motherfucker. This is Deadly Danger Dungeon.
Wait, why Mario?
Well, I couldn't really make my own pieces. I guess I could have a sculpture or something, but that was before I gave a shit about anything.
Okay, so I just everyone with it?
Yeah.
You're dead.
Well, what about my hit points?
Oh, no,
that's an instant death. You fall on spikes.
So you're right, spikes already appear.
No, these spikes are bigger.
Now.